We're going to have a look at some highlights now of race number 23 from the Bend Motorsport Park. We're 100 kilometres to the southeast of Adelaide. Turn the clock back and have a look at the way this one unfolded. This time, once again, from pole position, Jamie Whincup bolts down to turn number one. Shane van Gisbergen had a battle on his hands at turn two. He barely hung on. We had a very fast starting Craig Lowndes. He tried to press on with it, but couldn't close the deal. Kurt Kostecki unfortunately came out of turn six. There was a tangle then at seven, and it resulted in pretty significant damage in the right rear corner of that whole Commodore. Some of the runners opted to stop very, very early. That was a bizarre moment. Andre Heimgartner slamming heavily into the back of Garth Tander. Huge damage on the front of the Nissan. Todd Kelly showing his dismay. A lot of significant and expensive damage on the front of the Nissan. A couple of interesting strategies in the way in which they played with fuel loads this afternoon, remembering they had to drop 120 litres of Shell racing fuel into the cars. This was a bizarre moment for Lee Holdsworth. Drive shaft popped out of that car, fortunately recovered by one of our hard-working officials here, and Lee very wisely pulled the car off, and it didn't affect the outcome of the race. It did not trigger a safety car. Shane van Gisbergen was putting on a lot of pressure. In fact, he's reclaimed his own lap record. He lost it several times during the day, but he got it back again. He did a 1 minute 50.6. He was the lap record holder yesterday. The time's got a little bit faster today as the track rubbered in. We saw some great exchanges. That one between Nick Percat and Scott Pye was a beauty, but nobody could lay a glove on Jamie Whincup. He's been in fine form this weekend, stung by not getting on the podium yesterday for race number 23 of the championship today. Jamie Whincup grabs 150 points, sets himself up beautifully as we head to Sandown next.